Bruins from the line. Carlo takes the shot, scores! Looked like a harmless shot from the blue line, and it dribbled through Jordan Binnington, and Boston has a little insurance at 2-0.
There's a battle going down with Petrangelo. DeBrus down in the corner, and it's right back to the point. Kept it in, and what is this hit? Oh, one hopper that Binnington thought was going to go to his right, and somehow just popped right back to the left for him. Watch Carlo head up, a one hopper right there, a knuckleball that instead of going where he could push it.
So they just simply weren't happy, and they had to find a taker for Abisher, so they found one. Certainly a big salary depth.
Oh, and it's in!
Oh, no! Sebastian Caron, a nightmare bounce of the season.
Words cannot describe this goal.
The old 170-foot shot.
Lucky bounce, yes. 170-foot shot, you know that's going to bounce. You've got to get in front of the puck. You got to get in front of the bounce. If you can't get in front of the bounce, you can't guess on where it's going to bounce. Get deep in your net.
The Ducks now with their largest deficit of the night, trailing in Sunrise 5-1. Slow bouncing puck that goes in! Oh, my, Luongo waited for the puck to come to him. And somehow it took a bounce. I think Nate Thompson will get the goal. It looked harmless, but it's 5-2.
He senses that the Ducks are bearing down on him. It's Nate Thompson is coming down the middle. Cogliano's coming down the middle.
It's going to be Jackman's goal, I beg your pardon.
You know what? This is an inexcusable mistake by Luongo to take his midsection and move it to the right out from in front of the puck. You never do that.
Tipped across in front again for Petrov by Belanger. With 72 seconds remaining in the first, the puck is just dumped in, and it goes in. David Lenglund right at the blue line.
That goal is going to be replayed. He is not even over center ice yet. Before he dumps it, one hop. And the second hop, one hop, and just keeps coming right over. He doesn't even make it to center ice before he flips it. One bounce, and it is over the glove and in.
Landeskog trying to get loose. He'll carry it up ice himself. Option on net, score! It bounced away from Murray. It hops over his glove head.
A couple of the Avalanche players are watching it on TV. It just went directly to the left of Murray. If he makes a mistake at all, it's probably as he didn't come out far enough to challenge it. I mean, that just takes the craziest spot possible.
Got to change up.
Well,
his
the word around
regiment.
The league is he's the toughest goaltender by far, and he might be one of the toughest guys in the National.
Look out! As that one gets away from Talbot and goes into the net.
Another one here, just a chip in, and that's that little knuckle puck that takes one hop and isn't handled. And somehow for Talbot, he just mishandles this one. This one's straight into him. He thinks he's going to catch it. And you know what? Just a little lapse in judgment, concentration.
David, what do they say? They got busy sticks.
Very.
That's how coach.
Whoa! Whoa! The flip in from center ice by Kevin Klein. It's skipped. That's Crawford. And the Predators have taken a 2-1 lead at 5:15.
On the flip, Kevin Klein, Pete, he just gets over center ice. Flipped it way up in the air towards the net. It takes one bounce in front of Crawford, and it just sort of hits and then takes off up and over his stick shoulder, Pete. And yeah, the most surprised guy in the building is goaltender Corey Crawford.
Off the faceoff, Jake McCabe, number 29, carries. Looks like Kreider is going into the locker room with, and they score! I took my eye the puck. I apologize. I was watching Kreider head for the locker room. Sabres come down and score and grab the early lead in the opening minute of play.
All right, from the faceoff, Buffalo wins this one. They've had trouble getting out of their zone this year because they've got injuries on defense. That's just a dump in from the red line that goes in. Lundqvist gets a piece of it. There it is again. Just the bounce. And then,
oh,
actually,
boy.
Two bounces.
Boyboo scores! This puck just looked like it bounced by Allen with 10.5 seconds to go.
as Koivu just shoots this rolling puck. It bounces and then skips into the net. But look where Allen is. He is way too deep for any shot. I don't care where it's coming from. You never let, if you can help it, you never let a puck bounce in front of you as a goaltender, ever.
Glenn to get it to Muzzin. It never got there. Taken up to center by Tarasenko, and he loses it there. It's tipped away, and the Kings send it back down in, and it's scored! They just flipped it in, and it went by Brodeur and hopped up over him, and the Kings lead 6-4. We've seen it all tonight.
There are bounces, and then there are bounces. Let's be fair to Martin Brodeur here. King dumps in. Watch how high this bounces. Oh. It goes right. That's a water bottle goal. And Brodeur is just stunned. He doesn't know what to do. Watch, he loses the balance. He's going forward. He tries to jump at it at first.
And it gives the Red Wings a 2-0 lead.
Who scores? Oh. From center ice, Nyquist.
Yay. Those really stink. Halfway between the red line and the blue line. He gains the line right there. Boom. One hop.
On to center ice. Reinhardt steals it back and takes it. Scored! Reinhardt scored from center ice. He stole the puck away, let the shot go, and it beat Schneider.
And he's going to pick this puck off here. Right in the middle of the ice. Step in and throw it. And when that puck lands just by the hash marks, it jumps a little bit. And that's what throws Corey Schneider off. Look at it, it's rolling like crazy. That bouncing puck.
So Davidson spins it around the boards, but not out. Islanders have Park and Rieger up front. That's Davidson on the intercept and the clear. Back on D with Meyer.
And I like that they, oh, there's a goal. It bounces right by Toskala. Oh, you want to talk about a bad infield. A big hop. Bounces over the left pad of Vesa Toskala. A 200-foot goal.
Well, it's not how they draw it up, but it is a shorthanded goal, and for the Islanders, their eighth of the year.
Rob Davidson, watch this. Two hop, three hop, four, five, six, seven, and then all of a sudden, in true curling fashion, the sweeper gets there, and it bounces by. I mean, you got to put your body in front of that, but all kidding aside, Toskala thinks he has that, and it just scoots to his left. A bad infield hop. Doesn't lead to a single, but a home run right there for Rob Davidson. Gets his first goal as an Islander.